Today, I will be addressing some of the questions people who know me seem to have about cooking in my apartment. See, I've always been good with cooking. You know, I cook intuitively, even. I don't usually even seem to need a recipe. And I like to cook. When I'm feeling well, I like to eat well, and that usually involves cooking well. My parents probably don't realize how good I am at cooking because it's changed a lot since I last lived there. Anyways. Had a lot of practice. But one thing about my apartment is that, it's small. It's small, and there's actually no oven. Or stove, really. The fridge was bought for us by our landlords when we first moved in. But there's actually no place to put a stove in my kitchen. So a lot of questions come up about how I cook. Well, I have a hot plate. Well, range, actually. My mother calls it a hot plate, but a hot plate is a flat surface. This is a range. It has elements like a stove. It's, I don't know if you can see this, but it's about this wide. The elements like that on it. Enough that a small pot barely covers it, but they're high enough wattage that they boil water and cook a variety of other things. And I do have a toaster oven. I don't actually have a toaster, but I have a toaster oven. It's, that big. Kinda look like that. But, anyways. I have found cooking tins that fit into it. One small baking tin. Another deeper bread tin. And, cupcake tray. Made out of green silicone rubber. Now, I just used it to bake chocolate cupcakes. So, it's not exactly the cleanest, but as you can see, it's this nice, fun shade of green, and it actually fits my oven. So, I cook smaller portions, but I really am only cooking for two people. So I do, in fact, have an oven that I can use. I also do, in my own way, have a stovetop, so I get to cook all of the things with that. I have a microwave. It's on top of the fridge, because it's big, older than me, and it's the only place it'll fit. And I do have an electric frying pan that my fiancé, or husband's mother, and family were nice enough to give to us, which allows me to create meals that have higher portions. Mostly, though, everything I cook is the same as it was before, only more often and smaller. Like this bite-sized chocolate cupcake, which is shiny on top because of the hot chocolate mix used to make it, since I don't actually have cocoa right now, but they are really good cupcakes. They're crispy on the outside and soft in the middle. They're very tasty. Now, it doesn't actually seem to affect recipes. I can bake anything I want to, and the heat and the oven and the timing actually all stays the same. Because even though I've miniaturized all of the baking, I've also miniaturized the oven. So it doesn't actually throw off my cook times. It does make for smaller portions to be cooked at once. I tend to make half batches of things, or a lot of batches. But yeah, no, even in a small apartment with no actual oven, my cooking actually hasn't suffered. The only thing I can't be bothered to do is make toast. I've never been big on toast, and I don't actually have a toaster. I have a toaster oven, which actually probably is better as an oven than as a toaster. So I don't eat toast often. But I am in fact not suffering for my lack of cooking wares. I also have a lot of other small appliances, like a blender and the hand electric mixer and a coffee machine that for the longest time hasn't actually been used to make coffee at all and still hasn't been because I was allergic to coffee for a while until I had my appendix removed. Odd, huh? So yeah, no worries. Lots of cooking, lots of good eats, just in tiny bite-sized pieces.